four Zach Walker novels, they really began, they, all of them grew out of a single incident, which was when my wife and I were in the grocery store, and she has a habit of leaving her purse in the cart. And I thought, someone will steal it. It'll be just taken away. And I thought, what if I were to take her purse and hide it and scare her into thinking that it had been stolen, then she would never do that again. And I realized that that was not something I would do because I wanted to live. And it would be just, it'd be a terrible thing to do. But I thought, what if I were the kind of person who would do that? And I started thinking about the Zach character, a guy who's obsessed with safety and who's a very anxiety-ridden individual, who's kind of obsessive-compulsive. And so I started thinking about him, and I wrote one novel about him. And when we took that novel to a publisher in New York, they really liked it, and they said, well, we'd like you to do two. It had never occurred to me that it would be, there would be another novel. So I did a second one, and then having done the second one, they wanted me to do two more. So I ended up writing a total of four books about this character. He's not a usual hero in that, well, first of all, he means well, but he's very annoying. And he's not a heroic character. He's not courageous. He is completely ill-equipped to deal with bad, evil people. He has no skills in that area. And so I think that the humor in those books comes out of the fact that he's really not heroic. He has no skills to deal with bad people, yet confronts them. He falls into situations where he comes up against them, and he becomes tested and has to sort of figure out what to do. But he's no James Bond or Jason Bourne. Tap on the Window, that was the most recent book to come out here, and I think it's one of my best books, and it's about, unlike the other books, my hero is an actual detective. And one night he picks up a hitchhiker, a young girl. He doesn't want to pick her up because he doesn't think it's really a good idea to pick up young girls late at night when you're a middle-aged man. But the premise of it is, I mean, what if the hitchhiker that you picked up was not the same hitchhiker that you dropped off? What if something happened during that trip that was very, very strange? And that's the jumping off point for this novel. I think the author that had the most impact on me was in my teens was an American crime writer named Ross MacDonald. And he wrote a series of novels about a detective named Lou Archer. And those books made a huge impression on me when I discovered them. I think I found the first one when I was 15. And I liked that he could take the conventions of the mystery genre and use it to do other things, to do social commentary, to talk about environmentalism, to talk about dysfunctional families. And I loved his books, and I loved them so much that I wrote about them in a thesis for university. I corresponded with him. I actually ended up having dinner with Ross MacDonald. And I don't think any writers has had as much impact on me since. There's a lot of writers whose work I just adore. I just love, and far too many to mention. One of them's here at Quai de Polaire, Richard Price, whose work I think is brilliant. But there's so many writers out there who are just turning out absolutely beautiful work. A lot of my books over the years have been optioned in Hollywood to be made into films or television series, and inevitably they always seem to not happen. But finally, here in France, they are making a series. It's called L'Accident, and it's going to come on France 3 in October, starring Bruno Solo. And so we went up to see to the film shoot and met with Bruno and the other cast and the crew and watched them filming some scenes, and it was really exciting. And especially being the first one of my books to actually be made into something. And I think that they've really captured it. I mean, a lot of things are different. First of all, it's set in France, unlike America as the novel. But I think they really are capturing the essence and the heart of the novel, and I'm very excited to see it when it comes out. The accident is about a man whose wife dies in a car accident, and the police say that it was her fault, that she had been drinking, that she was so drunk she fell asleep at the wheel of the car and another car hit her. And this is so hard for him to believe because it goes against everything that he knows about her. It's not the kind of thing that she would do. So he's very tormented. I mean, what really happened? I mean, why was his wife living this kind of a life that he didn't know about? Why would she do that? Why would she be drunk? Why would she drive drunk? But maybe there's more to it than there seems to be.